You are too much.
It is the official presentation of the book, The Big Interviews, which is a compendium of interviews with some public figures in Nigeria. Present at this gathering are politicians and media practitioners, as the author highlights what inspired his work.
I didn't plan to write the book at all. I was just a journalist, a reporter, just enjoying my job. But as time went on, I met a gentleman, Dr. Koroma, who said this is like Oleana Farazi's work, Interview with History. You can turn it actually into something. You have interviewed a lot of Nigerians. I began to nurse the idea.
In their separate remarks, the former national chairman of the All Progressives Congress extols the role of the media in deepening democracy in Nigeria, just as the veteran journalist Mr. Sam Amukakbemu opposes the idea of death sentence for fake news.
Without the media, this country will not be where it is today. Without the media, the voiceless will never have a voice.
I do not think that death sentence is the answer to fake news.
The book is unveiled and presented. Beyond the unveiling, however, both the governor of Rivers State and the national chairman of the APC throw serious banters at each other.
I think on that same hard talk, the RGC big man, very, very big man, he write letters a lot. Even though there are no post office, I don't know where they are delivered. And then they ask him, and he spoke, he said, but they said your government, there was a lot of corruption in your government. I know Ribadu will testify to that. And he said, did they say I, that is himself, did they say he was corrupt? He said, no, that you superintended over a government that according to Transparency International was very corrupt. I have enough trouble right now, so I will add to the trouble, and so I will mention no name, but we can know the person. He knows the person, he has associated with the person, he's been groomed under the person, and he's still being overseen by the person.
The chairman of the APC said, it's good for leaders to preach what they practice, and not to preach what they don't practice. I remember during the chairman's second tenure to be governor of Edo State, he came to the villa to thank the then president who he described to have been interviewed. He said, thank you for one man, one vote. Today, do we have one man, one vote? You remember, in their own time, they had what they call occupied Nigeria. Nobody was arrested. Nobody was sent to jail. Nobody was detained. Nobody disobeyed any court order. Today, are they practicing what they're preaching?
No. Notwithstanding those criticisms, the embrace, the pleasantries among the leaders of the APC and the PDP at this forum tend to give credence to the popular saying that there is no permanent friend or enemy in politics. More reason why their supporters need to think twice before they act.